Felling is the most common practice we do in logging, urban or otherwise. It's also the most high risk, with serious injuries or fatalities occurring in the hundreds each year. So you gotta do it safe. This video is a short introduction on how to fell a tree, but it should not be your only training.
The first step to felling is checking the tree for decay and other defects that might alter its fall path or break off while the tree is falling. Inspect the tree for cavities along the lower trunk or cracks. If these occur, it is best to leave the felling to professionals trained to remove trees with these particular hazards. Also, look up into the canopy to inspect for a dead top or branches that may snap and fall while you're cutting. When selecting the area to fell the tree, always be sure there is adequate distance for the entire sweep. Check the felling arc for power lines and other structures. Look for potential targets if the tree shatters on impact and branches fly away from the tree. No one should be within a distance equal to 2 times the tree's height when felling. Tree height can be estimated by the methods described in the section on tree diameter and height measurements. The final step is to plan 2 retreat routes. The ideal routes are diagonal, about a 45-degree angle opposite from the intended direction of fall. Clear these routes of all brush, equipment, and other debris. The safest means of felling a tree is with the open face notch. This notch has the top cut slanted down at a 70-degree angle. The bottom cut is angled up at about a 20-degree angle, resulting in a perpendicular 90-degree meeting of the two cuts. This reduces the possibility of fiber pull, as the notch will not close, meaning the hinge wood does not break. These reduce the risk to the feller being struck by a fallen tree that rolls or kicks back off the stump. The biggest disadvantage of this notch is that it'll take off more wood near the base of the tree. This is usually the most valuable wood, so loggers often use a Humboldt notch instead. However, the Humboldt is beyond the capabilities of a weekend cutter. It is best to sacrifice a little wood volume than increase the risk of being seriously injured or killed. The back cut should be made about even with the corner of the notch, as the attached hidden wood itself prevents kickback. Leave an even row of wood behind a notch that's about a thickness of 5 to 10% of the tree's diameter. This is the hinge, and it controls the direction of fall. Cutting all the way through the hinge will result in an unpredictable fall. A wedge should be used every time a tree is felled. This aids in the control of the direction of fall. Once the back cut is made, a wedge should be used to complete the fell rather than continue to cut with a chainsaw. Make sure the felled tree has settled before starting to remove the branches. Remove the branches from the stump end first and work towards the top, since the crown will stabilize the fallen tree. Keep the trunk between you and the branches you are removing. Also, never stand on the downhill side of the tree or stand inside the fallen tree. It could rotate, crushing you in the process.